thanks for joining me today. And this is the final video, number 14 in the Believe It or Not series. Today's topic, how can Jesus' blood save anyone? That's a bloody religion. Do you expect me to teach my children that? But before we get started, be sure to like and subscribe for notifications on more videos like this, as well as others on faith, health, and beauty all year round. So, what do you think? How can Jesus' blood save anyone? That's a bloody religion. Do you expect me to teach my children that? Well, yes I do. And so does God. The prophecy of the coming of Jesus Christ was foretold by various prophets in the Old Testament who were sent by God, most namely the prophet Isaiah. In fact, Isaiah 53 gives such a detailed description of his life, death, and resurrection that the title of Messiah cannot be attributed to anyone else but Jesus. Read this chapter for yourself and keep in mind, this report was given hundreds of years before the birth of Jesus. I will touch on those five key verses and let the Bible itself explain how Jesus' blood can save anyone. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he hath borne our griefs, and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. He was oppressed, and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and he made his grave with the wicked, and with the rich in his death, because he had done no violence, neither was any deceit in his mouth. And finally, yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him. He hath put him to grief. When thou shalt make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed. He shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. Isaiah 53, verses 3 through 5, verse 7, and verses 9 and 10. It's not a religion. This is an act of sacrifice. If you're confused as to what religion is, listen to video number 5. Religion was thought up by man or men to control the masses. God permitted his prophets to tell of Jesus coming hundreds of years prior, not only so people would not lose hope for salvation, but also so this message could become engraved in the minds and hearts of the people, so they would not forget that he is God alone. Salvation is his to give, and it is your choice to accept or refuse this gift. He revealed this knowledge to his prophets so they could know without a doubt he is the one true God. That ye may know and believe me, and understand that I am he. Before me there was no God formed, neither shall there be after me. I am the Lord, and beside me there is no Savior. I have declared, and I have saved. Isaiah 43, verses 10 through 12. God instructed that these truths be taught to every generation, and all thy children shall be taught of the Lord, and great shall be the peace of thy children. Isaiah 54, verse 13. Now imagine that. God wants every child to know of his promise and have peace knowing salvation can be theirs through him alone. You ask me, do I expect you to teach that to your children? I ask you, is peace in the knowledge that Jesus saves by directive of the living God something you want for your children? Or are you worried about what the world thinks? What is wrong with the phrases, Jesus' blood, the blood of Jesus, by the blood, and many others which use the word blood? Blood courses through your veins, doesn't it? If you're cut, you will bleed, right? And if you were in need of a transfusion, you would want someone of the correct blood type to give you a few pints if it meant life or death, I'd imagine. If you've given birth, you shared your blood, the umbilical cord, to keep your child or children nourished and alive for 9 months, or they would not be here. So what on earth is your issue with Jesus' blood? Don't forget, you watch movies and television shows filled with violence, shooting, stabbing, taking lives, accosting women, beating, and only God knows what else with graphic depictions of blood, and you have a problem with someone speaking of the blood of Jesus. Is it only okay if you pay for the price of bloody entertainment, but not that he paid the price for your sins by his blood? I don't understand it. We could go on and back and forth, but I need to set this straight now. I'll tell you the same thing that Peter told the people who marveled at the miracles of the disciples, but denied Christ. Better yet, I'll let him tell you. Repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, when the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. And he shall send Jesus Christ, which before was preached unto you, whom the heaven must receive until the times of restitution of all things, which God hath spoken by the mouth of all his holy prophets since the world began. Acts 3, verses 19 through 21. Life is in the blood. I do pray you will receive it. Now, if you want to know more about the life of Christ and more about this topic, about Jesus' blood, salvation, and just about Jesus Christ's life, I recommend you watch a movie called The Passion of the Christ. As a matter of fact, Rascal Entertainment's Playmaker, Ama Productions, and myself did a podcast on this the 31st of December. And I'll have a link so that you can click it on the right and give it a listen and a watch. It may answer some questions that you have, and we just share with you what a powerful and informative video this is on the life of Jesus Christ. And I hope you will be moved to watch the movie yourself, come to your own conclusions, and learn more. So I hope this video has been helpful for you today, as well as this entire series. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I've enjoyed speaking with you. If today's video has been helpful to you, give it a thumbs up. And don't forget, I have more videos available on topics like these, other topics on faith, health, and beauty all year round. At this point, I have over 850 videos available. Yes, I'm not kidding. I can't believe it myself, but I do. And you're welcome to check them out at any time. You can go to the video section, type in a topic, and see what comes up for you. And while I'm on this, thank you so much for your support. I really appreciate your watching these videos, commenting, sharing, and again, I hope they've been of immense help to you. Now, if you have a YouTube channel you want me to check out, type the name below in the comments, and better yet, leave a link for me to click on. I'll check it out, and I'll support you and give you a follow as well. So, I hope you're having a wonderful weekend. Continue to read, research, and learn, and follow the path that you've chosen for yourself. I wish you nothing but blessings, and I support you all the way. If there are any topics you'd like me to speak on, let me know in the comments below as well. I'll be happy to do that, and I'll be happy to have a conversation with you as well. So, that's it for now. Thanks for joining me. Continue to have a wonderful day, and be blessed.